Hi guys, welcome to the video, and in this lesson we're going to focus on a term called moles. Now in chemistry, when we use the word moles, we're talking about the amount of substance. Mole is a type of measurement that we use in chemistry, just for amounts. Now in simple terms, a mole, is the relative molecular mass or the relative atomic mass in grams. And this is a definition that you would be wise to remember, because chemists will continually refer to this term of mole. Now again, we can sometimes in chemistry you see the word mole and it's spelled M-O-N, mole. Or sometimes we can talk about moles, which is M-O-L-S. But they're both talking about the amount of substance or the relative formula mass or molecular mass in grams. The mole of any substance contains the same amount of atoms or particles. Now, if we have a mole of any substance, it contains 6.02 times 10 to the 23. And what that means is 6.02 with 23 zeros after it. It's a very large number. So the mole of any substance will contain that many atoms, ions, or particles. And this is called Avogadro's constant. Now there is an equation that we can use that relates the relative formula mass and moles. And the triangle looks something like this. You do the mass in grams at the top, the moles and the relative molecular mass or the relative atomic mass. Let me give you guys an example. What if we had 12 grams of carbon and we wanted to know the amount in moles? Well, using this equation, we do the mass in grams and we divide it by the relative atomic mass. Looking at our question, the mass in grams is 12. And I would divide that mass in grams by the relative atomic mass, which for carbon is 12 also. So we've got 12 for the mass in grams divided by the atomic mass, which is 12. That would give us 1 mole. So 12 grams of carbon is just 1 mole. What if we had 2 moles of magnesium? What would the mass in grams be of 2 moles of magnesium? Well, again, we use our triangle. We know how many moles we've got, which is 2. And we know the relative atomic mass of magnesium. Look at our periodic table, it's 24. And according to our triangle, we just multiply those two numbers together. So 2 times 24 would give us our mass in grams, which is 48 grams of magnesium. So 2 moles of magnesium has a mass of 48 grams. We'll do one more. What about if I had 6 grams of hydrogen? Again, using my triangle, I know that I've got 6 grams, that's the mass. So it would be 6 divided by the relative atomic mass of hydrogen, which is just 1. 6 divided by 1 gives us 6 moles. So if I had 6 grams of hydrogen, the amount that I have is just 6 moles. Okay guys, thanks for tuning in. Stay in touch for another video.